ggLeap makes it very easy for your gamers to quickly play the games that they want to play. By default, ggLeap will show the top 5 games in your venue. But as the gamer begins to play different games, these will be replaced by the games that they like to play. In addition to the top 5, we also have a games menu which can be accessed either in the nav bar or by clicking all games. And from the all games menu, we can access any of the configured launchers that are available. So by default, we will automatically detect which launchers are installed and show them here. If there are more than 4, they can be found in the game launcher section within the apps. As we scroll down, we can see the top games that are in your particular venue. This is based on the number of game launches. And below that is the full list of games that you have enabled on the web admin. The expectation is that you would install all of the games that you wish your gamers to have access to, and then enable those games on the web admin so that this list of games is accurately showing which games are installed on your hardware, on your software, I should say, so that the games can be quickly launched. In addition to being able to launch the games, players can log into their own accounts here, but also if you have configured it, for example, on Apex, I have configured this one. For any of the games that require a login to an account such as Steam or Epic or Origin or any of the launchers, on the web admin, you can configure in advance licenses that can be used to automatically log players into those games without exposing the passwords. So for example, in Apex, I have configured a Just Play account, which allows the gamer to automatically borrow one of your licenses that you've pre-configured. Now, if the gamer has played before on a certain license and perhaps have saved a game, they can click this button to automatically take the license that they were previously given and continue their experience by logging into that same license, or they can simply choose one of the licenses that's available. Whenever we choose one of these licenses, that license is then in use for that gamer, which means it's not available for other gamers until that user has completed that game, which will return the license to the pool, allowing it to be available for any other gamer in your venue. And this means that you can have all of the games installed on all of the computers, but you can also have a small number of licenses in a license pool that allow your gamers to automatically log into those accounts without having to buy an individual account for each game for each PC. Gamers are able to use the filters on the left side to filter games based on tags. Now, these tags are added by default by the ggCircuit team, but it is possible for you to go into the web administrator and add, edit, or delete any of those tags if you want to reorganize these games. It's also possible for the gamers to filter the games by games that are free to play versus games that are that require purchase. It's also possible to filter by games that you've enabled to make available to borrow so that the automatic license management system will work for those games. In addition to the games, there's also the apps menu. These apps should be configured by you on the web administrator depending on which apps you want to make available to your gamers. Some of our venues are happy to make internet access be a thing for the gamers, others are not. So you can simply go into the web administrator and choose from any of the apps. And basically any app that will execute on Windows operating system can be enabled here as well. So there are hundreds of apps available to be enabled, and if there is a new app that becomes available, then simply let us know. We can add that into the system so that you can then enable it as well. That's all for the games and apps video. See you on the next one.